Road construction can be frustrating for anyone, but imagine what could happen if an organ donation got stuck in a backup.
It's a risky scenario when someone's life is on the line. A scenario Boyd Hubert reports a whole chain of people recently went to great lengths to avoid.
The Gift of Life Transplant House near Mayo Clinic is an unlikely place to learn about one's boyhood misdeeds.
I grew up with a colorful life in a small town.
John Neuenschwander was known to all the officers in his North Dakota hometown.
Oh, you think?
Nothing too serious.
And will the following students come down to my office?
But good background for the story you're about to hear. In October, John, who now lives in Fargo, was on his way to a Mayo operating room like this to receive a donor heart being delivered to Rochester from the Twin Cities when his surgeon had a concern.
One stretch of road causing headaches for some travelers is Highway 52.
For months, construction had been slowing and even stopping traffic on the route John's new heart was supposed to be traveling in an unmarked car.
I was afraid, you know, to have a poor outcome, obviously.
Mayo transplant surgeon Mauricio Villavicencio picked up the phone.
Yes, that's definitely a new one for me.
Mitch Elson, lieutenant with the Minnesota State Patrol, pondered.
Time wasn't on our side. They needed the heart down there ASAP. We didn't have flight available. We had cars.
You are looking at video taken from the dashboard of the State Patrol squad car carrying the heart destined for John Neuenschwander's chest.
Precious cargo.
Very much.
Trooper Mike Pavier was the driver.
Speed range from 80 to 100. Everyone yielded, moved to the shoulder.
All right, sir.
That's Trooper Pavier's body cam as he pulls over near Zimbrota to transfer the heart to a Rochester district trooper. Also getting out of the car is a Mayo technician, escorting the heart packed in ice in that cooler being pulled from the back seat. A heart about to be loaded.
Pretty crazy.
In Trooper Quentin O'Reilly's car.
I'll put that up front.
Will it fit?
Hopefully.
We didn't talk too much. We just got to convert or kind of hand it off. And we went.
There you go.
I looked at it a few times, you know, just looking at a big old cooler sitting there, you know, a foot away from me and kind of think it's pretty surreal that it's right there.
With lights and siren, Trooper O'Reilly approaches the Mayo Clinic emergency entrance.
Next left, correct?
Inside, he removes the heart, which is then whisked away to its recipient, waiting, chest already open.
They delivered my heart.
John benefited greatly
from
that speed delivery.
As soon as I implanted the heart and they started beating very strongly.
In your 300 heart transplants, have you ever enlisted the State Patrol before?
No, this was the first time. No, definitely.
I'm not ready to lose him. He means a lot to me.
3 months later, Ruth Ann Halls, John's partner, can't stop thinking about those troopers.
You saved my loved one's life. You had a part in that.
If only.
Big day.
They.
Very big day.
Could meet them.
Are you the guys?
Yes, sir.
Wow.
Nice to meet you.
Thank you, thank you. It means a lot.
Congratulations.
Yeah, thank you.
How you doing?
Better than I deserve.
Good. I've been praying for this for a long time. Very thankful to these folks.
Thank you doesn't really cut it.
The young John Neuenschwander, who kept the cops jumping.
Just so appreciate what you did.
Now stands indebted to the troopers who helped keep John pumping.
You saw the red lights from the highway patrol, you went, oh God. Now it's a little different. Thank God.
Boyd Hubert, Carol 11 News, Rochester.
John continues to do well after his heart transplant. He hopes to be cleared to return to Fargo by the end of the month.
I love the backstory on that. Kept him jumping, now they keep
boy.
Him pumping.
That's just a great story.
Another great story. Yeah. It's just so unbelievable just to see the footage of obviously how fast they went and what difference every second made, right?
Exactly.
I love that.